because we were meeting Jared. Because we went to watch the Giants game. They let us park at the Chase Center, then we walked to the...
Oh, really?
Yeah, they let us park. They opened it. I think it was doing a playoff game. You know, most of the, so they opened it, and then so we were able to park in Chase, but then we had to walk to...
I still haven't visited Austin.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the hot dogs, dude! Yeah, man.
Bring my hoodie and everything.
Yeah, dude.
I'm already burning up.
What's up, man?
Hey.
Oh shit.
So they can cut it off from Triple Alley if they want.
So there's also an entrance you can get in and out too, right?
Guys, who is this again?
Not really.
Oh, it's okay. Thank you very much.
You don't want to
Thanks, Sue.
Interested in fantasy. I'm not that. It doesn't interest me. And then suddenly I said, okay, all right, if you just stop bugging me, I'll read them. I read the first book and I read the second. I read all three books within 2 days. And I said, I have to direct this. So I called my agent and I said, I want to direct this movie. And she said, well, there's 25 other directors who want to direct it as well. So it was a long interviewing process. I think I eventually got the job because I had worked with kids in the past, and I thought I would have the ability to cast the right three kids. And that's really what it was. That's what the studio told me. But it was a long process, and I had to meet with J.K. Rowling, fly to Scotland, and explain to her for about 4 hours what my vision for the film was. And afterwards, because I didn't know what was going to happen afterwards, she said, I see the film the same way, so I knew I got a job.
Well, let's dive into the characters, because those three characters are timeless.
Yeah.
And it's actually, I think, hard for those actors to be seen as anything else than Ron, Hermione, and Harry. Did you know when you see them? How many times they audition? Like, what are you looking for when you're looking for an iconic character?
You're basically looking for chemistry between the three kids. I mean, we needed to know that they could work well together, and it was, Hermione was very easy. We met Emma early in the process, and she was the first choice of everyone. Ron Weasley was equally fairly easy. Rupert Grint was just, he was Ron Weasley. Daniel Radcliffe went through a long process. Joe Rowling and I, J.K. Rowling and I,
Yeah, he called
me
Jeff.
Uh-huh.
Do you get that?
we knew when we saw Dan's screen test that he was Potter. We felt that he had this sort of haunted quality, that he could grow into the role. But it took the studio a long time to convince him to make the offer to Dan. You know, it really, one of the executives said, well, by his fall, do you believe it? By his fall, we will cast Dan Rex. And he's
going on to. He's gone on to be such an exceptional actor. He really has broke out of the mold of beyond Harry Potter. It's a great role. So it's a statement that he's unbelievable that these movies are more than 20 years old. And when you get into a project like that, I guess you can only hope that they're going to be popular. So this is how much money we need to get. Does that cost your money?
Well, this is not my first movie, because the first movie, it was a newer guy. So if I threw out...
Did you get this from Universal Studios?
No,
the jacket?
No, this is a thrift store.
Ooh, even better.
And this is a Wicked Witch of the West, actually.
That's a what?
Wicked Witch of the West.
Oh, wow.
And it's actually the same high collar as I made the hat from scratch.
Oh, nice. I love the quills.
And I made the sorting hat.
Oh, shit. Good job.
That's a little leather jacket from the thrift store 20 years ago.
Nice.
And then just this last Halloween is when we motorized it and did the whole thing for our big bag. And now we got
you guys got the eyes down right there.
Yeah. Fabric stiffener. Sewed it together and then I pinned it and shaped it with fabric stiffener. But he still moves enough to be a puppet.
Right.
Like, 100 men have never been able to giving the team passion and energy. And it's just got a lot going on. I love it. And I got to meet Bruce Posey for the first time last year. And that was...
Don't you think Bose could have played Haggard?
Bose could have played Haggard. He's got me. They always say, and for great actors in movies as opposed to television, your head has to be kind of big. And your head, it's really true. All big movie stars have bigger heads. And I saw Bose, and I was like, this could be in the room.
For real. You know that when Bose got called up to the majors, there wasn't a helmet so good as head?
I heard.
It's no joke. And a six pack of beer fit inside three Bose's helmet.
Really?
One pack of beer? Who's that big? He's a big man. All right, so in layman's terms, because I can only imagine how complex the answer is to this, how do you attack a popular book, like beyond popular, that's not even the right word, beloved, and adapted for a screen? How do you even start the approach?
Well, I think when I started working as a screenwriter, the hardest thing about Harry Potter, and they're now doing an HBO Max series about Harry Potter, so you get to see every chapter of the book, which is great. We didn't have that luxury, so we had to figure out a way to get this movie down under 3 hours. And when we finished the first cut of the movie, it was 2 hours and 55 minutes. And we showed it at a test screening in Chicago, and all the parents were like, it's too long. And all the kids were like, way too short. So I had to go back, and the first movie was like 2 hours and 43 minutes or something. And kids will sit there and watch it. That was the hardest part. The hardest part was to leave out things like Peeves, which is one of my favorite characters in the first book. And that is the toughest thing.
Do you know how many parents go thank you that they got 2 hours and 43 minutes without being able to their children?
That is the greatest. Because his movies are not under 90 minutes. So yeah, it's a good feeling.
Was that kind of happened in Italy and going over to Scotland and London as well for interviews?
Scotland to meet Sir Roland. And we did shoot in Scotland. Yeah. Shot most of the
time. And there's 25 other people under the dog.
Well, it was interesting because my daughter was thrilled. We basically, to keep the family together, at that point we were like a movable feast. And it was just, Monica and I took all the kids to London, and I went to school London, and I did their trip. I produced Prisoner Basketball, so it was awesome to direct it. So we were there for 4 years. So all my kids went to school in London, fell in love with the city, and then part of it is like in London dreaming of hopefully I would go to the Giant Kid. And I was literally going to say on, not that the Giant brought me back, they were one of the reasons, but the fact that we had done like 360 days of college shooting on the first 2 months, that it was kind of time to go back.
The last few years, we've been able to enjoy the Broadway cast of Harry Potter here at the park. Has anybody been that night here with them? They're so awesome, right? Did you have a chance to see it on Broadway?
Yeah, I saw Monica and I saw Cursed Child in London. So we flew to London and saw it in one day. So we went to the Met, there was a 2 o'clock show, and it was phenomenal. And I think that's the only, I would love to return.
I want to do it. Yeah. So
I'll tell him not to use later.
There's no way.
Is there a sports movie in the making for you?
Got a little kid, dude.
The funniest thing is, a few years ago.
Oh, sure.
this Del Bar looks dope.
Yes!
Thank you for our childhood,
yes, man.
Such a good movie, dude.
Thank you.
Oh,
thanks for thank you.
Let's see if this works. It's gonna be black on.
Extra cheese, man. That's the best way to
you
go.
You gotta go
with
plenty of cheese.
Hell yeah.
It's the only way to eat nacho.
And sour crop for me too, yeah, man. Oh, hell yeah. I swear to God.
I don't know how you go ahead and try it.
I would have
Ha ha ha!
picking up some big words from Miguel hanging out.
Oh yeah, they'll do last call.
Do they do that raffle thing?
I haven't heard.
They're all Giants. That's all the lady Giants. Outside was just saying, "What would you have?" It's like one of those. It's like a derby paddle.
Yeah. Alejo!
Oh, it's gone.
Alejo!
Nada.
Let's go get sorted.
I lost my grapple. One more.
Thank you.
We have the longest walk, dude.
Oh, we have the longest walk.
Yeah. We got our money's worth, man.
Before we play ball, there are a few do's and don'ts we need to discuss first.
so everyone can fully enjoy the game. To start, please be aware that you are in a baseball game and pay attention to your surroundings, especially if you like to tweet. For your safety, be alert at all times and watch out for any blind bats and balls, even if you're behind a net. Please do not interfere with any ball in your way. Doing so may affect the outcome of the game and result in you being escorted off the premises. Smoking and vaping are not permitted anywhere inside Oroville Park, as we are a smoke-free facility. Don't be afraid to anyone around you at the exit of Blackout and Woodward. Thank you for listening. Now sit back, grab some garlic fries, and enjoy the game. Fans here to throw out tonight's ceremonial first pitch on Harry Potter Night. Please welcome filmmaker and director of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone and the Chamber of Secrets, Chris Columbus. Whenever you're ready, Chris. My God. Thanks, Chris.
For being here, enjoy the game. My God, dude, I don't know. That's just what they requested. They said drive. 36, 37
minutes. I'm thinking Ravenclaw. He's pretty smart. He knows how to handle himself.
Ravenclaw.
Under Ravenclaw. All right, what about manager Gabe Kaplan?
Oh, he's a Gryffindor. Total leader, knows what he's doing, kind, and yet he'll fight for what he needs.
Gryffindor. What about Patrick Bailey? Patrick Bailey, I think he's a Gryffindor because he's my favorite player. I'm Gryffindor. Gryffindor, there you go. What about Brian Trott? Which house would Brandon Crawford be at?
I think he's really chill. I don't see him really aggressive, but he's really also chill, just chill.
Ellie De La Cruz, he plays for the Reds.
Slytherin.
Good answer.
Ellie De La Cruz.
What was Jack not going to
thank you.
great pleasure to welcome you all to Oracle Park, the home of your 2023 San Francisco Giants. Tonight's contest is the second game of a three-game series between the visiting Cincinnati Reds and your San Francisco and remove your hats as we honor America with a national anthem. Performing the Star Spangled Banner, please welcome Phoebe Yates.
Thank you.
up, man?
I'm loud.
All good? Okay. Cool, cool, man.
Garbage.
He's a homer. You suck,
it's like super dead.
That's some bullshit.
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 Yeah.